Let's take a look at how we can use modules and install packages. So up here, what I have is a little module that I'm going to use as my sample. So what you'll notice is I've got a little function that I'm calling display, takes two parameters, message, which is whatever we're going to print out, and then an isWarning, which is just a flag. We're going to set that to false by default. And then what you'll notice is that if it is a warning, we'll just print out, this is a warning. And if it's not, then we'll just not print that. In either case, we will print out the message. So I now want to use that from my demo here. And so what I can do is I can say import helpers. And now that I've done that, now I have that little display that we just saw available to me. Let me actually just put that kind of side by side so that way we can see that. Whoops, let me hit the right button. There we go. Cool. And so now let me go ahead and start using that. So what I could do is I could say helpers.display and then sample message. And so now if I run my little demos.py and make my IntelliSense go away, there we go, Python, and then my demos.py. And sure enough, we got our little sample message. And if I would have passed in true, puts it out onto the next line there. Let me just readjust. There we go. Cool. And rerun this. Now you'll notice that it prints out, this is a warning, and my sample message. So just like that, I can import in modules. That's all there is to it. Now, if I wanted to always make display available without having to use that little bit of helpers.syntax, then I could say from helpers, import, and then if I wanted everything, I could use the asterisk, or if I just wanted that display, then I could just simply say import display, and now I can say display, sample message, and now if I rerun this, now what we're going to notice is that sample message showing up twice because I called display twice, and it's the exact same thing. The only difference is simply how we did the import. Okay. See if I can't. Right there is the exact sweet spot without it putting in line breaks. Cool. So that's how I could go in and do that. But now let's take a look at how we could set up a virtual environment and install a package into there. So to set up my virtual environment, let me clear my screen here. The way that I do this is by saying Python tickm venv for virtual environment, and then I'm actually just going to say venv second time. Now, that second parameter there, this one right here, that is the name of the folder that I'm creating. So when you look at that syntax, you might be thinking, well, why am I typing venv twice? The second one is the name of the folder. The first is the command. You're going to notice most people will either just do venv for virtual environment, or sometimes they'll just do env for just environment. I really like that venv, so that's what I'm going to stick with. And I'll hit enter. And you'll notice that VS Code then pops up and says, hey, we noticed a new virtual environment has been created. Do you want to select it for the workspace folder? Now, what this is going to do is this is going to tell VS Code about all of the packages that I'm going to be using. It's going to know to look at that folder for all of those packages. What's the impact, you ask? Well, the impact is going to be that now VS Code can help me out. VS Code is now going to know everything that's there and will be able to show me the IntelliSense. You almost always want to click yes on this because I'm going to want that help from VS Code. So I'm going to click yes, and now it set that up inside of VS Code. But I still want to set that up inside of my local execution environment. And the way that I'll do that is by saying current directory, and then venv scripts, and then activate.ps1. Now, the way that I know that I'm using my virtual environment is right here at the very beginning, you'll notice that it's showing me the name of the virtual environment. If you see that, you're now using that virtual environment. If you don't see that, you're not using the virtual environment. Now that's for my code execution. How do I know if VS Code is using the right thing? Well, I can actually see that down here. Let me actually zoom in on that, hopefully make that a little bit easier to read. So down here on the lower left-hand corner, you'll notice right here, this is where it's telling me the environment that it's using. So I want to see my VENV there. That's the name of my virtual environment. Now I know that VS Code is using it. And again, the impact here is that VS Code will now be able to help me out. So when we install Colorama, which we'll do in a moment here, it's now going to know that inside of VS Code, and I'll get my IntelliSense. So let me now do my installation. So we'll say pip install, and then Colorama. Now, by doing it that way, it's just going to install Colorama that one time, and that's it. Typically, the way that you'll want to do this is by using a requirements.txt file. So I'm just going to create a brand new file. Just going to call it requirements.txt. No magic. It's just a text file. That's it. It's in my current directory, just a text file, and I'm going to type out Colorama. Boom. And now I'll go ahead and say pip install and then tick R for a requirements file, requirements.txt. And that will now do my installation. Now, it's going to install it into the virtual environment. How do I know that? Well, because I've activated it, and because one more time, I'm seeing that little VENV right there at the beginning. Now, I'm getting a little error message here telling me that pip needs to be upgraded. You'll probably get that like half the time that you run pip, I swear. And that's fine. You can go ahead and upgrade it. I'm not going to worry about it for right now. I've now got Colorama installed. Let's put Colorama to use then. And so I'm going to put that to use inside of my helpers.py. Because printing out this is a warning, that's kind of cheesy. Let's change colors here. So I'm going to say from Colorama, and I'm going to say import, and then we'll say init, which is what I'm going to need for Colorama, and I'm going to need my my foreground colors, which are going to be like that. Cool. And why are you giving me green squigglies? Colorama. Ah, there we go. Cool. So now, let me go ahead and update this so that if it is a warning, we'll print it in red. And if it's not a warning, then we'll just print it in the normal color. So we'll go ahead and say else, and then we'll just print message. And you know what? We'll print the normal messages in green. The way that I do that is by saying for dot, I need to make sure that my casing is correct. There we go. So now we'll say for dot blue, and then our message. Otherwise, we'll go ahead and say for dot red, and then our message. Now, if you're curious as to how I know to do that, even though I got my casing wrong on four, the way that I knew to do that is because I've worked with Colorama in the past. Again, if you're ever looking to do something, just search the interwebs. Honestly, that's how I discovered Colorama. I went, hey, I want to be able to display different colors when I print. I did a search, found Colorama, and here we are. That's exactly what I did. Okay. So now I've got my little red if it's a warning, blue if it's not. We're good. Let's go ahead and save that. And if we come back over here to our demos, what we'll notice is one time we said true, so we should see that in red. The other time we didn't do anything, we should see that in blue. Let's run it. So we'll say Python and then our little demo, hit enter, And sure enough, our warning is in red, our non-warning is in blue. So what we saw in this demo and what we saw in this module is how we can work with our own modules and how we can work with external packages and how we can set up a virtual environment. Pretty much every application that you're ever going to be creating is going to have some level of requirement for installing packages. That if you're going to be using cognitive services, if you're going to be using Flask, if you're going to be using Django, you're going to be installing all of those various packages. And that's how we do it. Set up a virtual environment, set up a requirements text file, list the packages that you want, and then it's simply pip install from there. And that is how we work with packages and modules in Python.